Epa, what's your look at the block, eh? What can I start the video on? Hey, this is unbelievable, eh? I'm just preparing myself for the filming, and Captain Blush, you can do it again, eh?
Yes, because maybe this time you'll be a bit faster, eh?
Yeah, of course, this time will be faster, but still, I will start like I always do. Friends, salute and welcome to the Princess Brothers RC channel. The channel where we will try to film as many different players as possible.
Hey, why have you stopped now?
You, yeah, but you have distracted me.
Don't get distracted.
The channel where we will try as many different players as possible. Yeah, of course, eh? Because maybe some of you are still wondering if you should buy your first plane. No, don't wait, eh? I mean, hey, you will what?
What?
You will see that flying RC planes can be the best hobby in your life, and of course, we are trying to show you that from an amateur point of view, eh? Captain Blockley, you have totally distracted this time. What kind of video will this be? I don't even know how to start the video, eh? Right now. Because I'm just checking something here, eh?
What?
What the hell is this, eh?
What?
What's this, eh?
Yeah, I don't know.
This happened in the hangar?
I just brought
because,
it here.
I didn't saw this before on this
plane. It was on the shelf. I just took it out.
Watch. Did something happen to the plane? Hey!
Hey, I'm laughing, but I'm not laughing because...
Of course you're laughing, because hey, I didn't saw this before on the plane. I mean, it's not hard to fix, but what's this, eh?
Hey, that's not me, that's you.
Yeah, it was not me, it was you, eh? But this is amazing.
Didn't George Costanza say, it's not me, it's you, eh?
That George said, it's not me, it's you, eh? Now, of course, viewers, we are way off now. The channel, when we what?
Film.
We don't edit nothing. What you see is what you get, and that's it, eh? Of course, this is the last stand for an amateur pilot, eh? Because here we show you all. If the plane is flying good, we show you that, and if we crash, we show you also that. Because crashes do happen from time to time, but of course, we're all hoping not so many. Now, what's the point of today? Now, you can already see here something really, really beautiful. And the friends who are following our channel, you will already recognize these planes. These are two birds from the Hobby King, and we are trying to create here the collection of Smule from, I don't know how we call this, from 700 to 900 millimeter wingspan or something like that. The warbirds from Hobby King, because this is their collection. We already have the two planes that you have already seen that we were filmed. This one, look how sexy it is. Beautiful and sexy.
Yes.
Hawker Hurricane. I think that this is the 750 millimeter wingspan. They all run on the same battery. 850
yes.
milliamp free cell batteries, and that is the most beautiful thing, because all these planes you fly on the same batteries. So if you have four batteries, you can stack them in every plane you have in this collection. It doesn't matter, you don't need to have a different battery for every plane. This collection is perfect, and the point is that the planes in this collection are really scale. I mean, for me, is such a dimension of this small version, I don't think that you can find more scale small planes on the market, and that they still fly, and that they still have the ailerons, the rudder, the elevator. Now, of course, they don't have the landing gear, because then this would be expensive planes. They come pretty cheap, but they also already come with the gyro inside, and that is something that I will say to Hobby King, because they provide you with the gyro if you're the beginner pilot, and sometimes on the hand launches of these planes, it does come really handy, so you don't crash your plane. But later, when you're in the air, free mistakes up, then you can turn switch off the gyro and you fly your plane on your own.
Yes.
And again, it comes really handy when you're landing the plane, so the plane stays in one piece and you're one happy pilot all over again.
Mm-hmm.
Hawker Hurricane, the second one, of course, this was the first one that we have filmed. This one, the A1, the Skyrider. For me, I mean, this plane is unbelievable still, eh?
Yes.
This is so scale for such a small plane that, I mean, I'm blown away. Look at this, eh? Look how sexy it looks, and this one flies so good. Now, I will tell you the truth, that by now, this one, I rather fly this one than this.
Oh, yeah?
But still, if you have the assist of the gyro, they fly pretty sexy. And in fact, I still didn't fly this plane with the normal rudder, because this is the plane that I was flying three flights with the reverse rudder, and every time I was thinking, hey, why the hell do I lose the signals all the time? If I want to go to the left, why the plane is going to the right? Yeah, of course, because I had the reverse rudder. Now we have, they still have another two planes that I will have to get. They have the B-51 Mustang, the iconic plane. They have the Hawker Tempest, I think, also. Mm-hmm. But today we are having the second one from the USA Air Force. Well, that is so iconic.
This is the most iconic silhouette of the plane. Eh?
Yeah, after the Mustang, I really think the Corsair
silhouette.
Silhouette. I mean,
shape
this is
of
silhouette.
The plane. Yes.
This is so iconic silhouette. It's the same as me as when I see the German Luftwaffe Stuka. With that wings, I mean, you can't miss it. And also, you can't miss the Corsair. But these planes really fly good, and they were really good.
Do you know why the wings are shaped like this, eh?
Why?
Because they had put in so big engine, they had to put a bigger prop, so to get the clearance of the prop, they
clearance from the ground? Yes. They had to put the wings down, but then the pilots had the problem to steer on the runway. They have to zigzag, so they have seen where they were driving, because the front of the plane was so high that they didn't see through.
Yes.
But when they were in the air, I mean, you could hear, I really watched the videos, you can hear when the Corsair is coming. It's really like a whistle. I mean, that must have been really scary for the Axis soldiers to hear the scream.
No, you can hear. What did you say? What soldiers?
Axis.
What's Axis?
You had the Alliance and the Axis during the Second World War. The Axis, you call them. Yeah, yeah.
You never heard of
yeah,
before.
You've never heard this?
No.
Yeah. The Axis soldiers, that were the Japanese, the Germans and that. And you have the Alliance. The Americans, the British, yeah.
Axis
forces and Alliance.
No, yeah, no.
But who cares? Viewers in the USA, you will understand what I have said. I have even learned that from some Second World War games, say, on the
computer. Yeah, well, my eyes were now so big, eh?
But of course, today we're gonna see this beauty, because this was a must, eh? I mean, when I have already these two planes and this came out not long ago, I said to myself, what the hell, I will click on this one, because this one must be in this small collection. I also hope in the future that they will get those two other back in the store, in the stock, so I will be able to order them. But today we're going to see this, and let's check what does it have. 750mm wingspan. Again, it is the same size as that one. The length, the weight, 420 grams. Now this means that for this one, if you will fly, you already need the license here in the Europe, because it is
what's that, 12 ounces?
Yeah,
1 ounce is 30 grams.
I don't know, but it is more than 250 grams, so
wait,
that means that
1 ounce is 30 grams.
No,
so 10 ounces is 300 grams.
The motor,
12.
I don't want to bother you with the KVs. Yeah, I don't know.
12
know.
ounces,
yeah, something like that.
Yes.
But I have told you, you need the license for this one, eh? It is heavy enough, eh? I won't bother you with motor KV, because motor KV, I can tell you that it has the 20 amp ESC, but that are just the stuff that the manufacturer put inside, the size of the ESC, the KVs, which I presume that they have calculated okay, and I don't have to worry about that. Who cares about the KVs on these planes? Who cares about that? And the ESC? I presume that if I will stuck the battery in, I will be one happy pilot again, and I will have
well,
the good
I will
plane.
Be happy when you will open the box, eh?
But if it will not fly, then I will start to guess, hey, what the hell is with those KVs? But those KVs come more important for me, sometimes even on the prop planes, but mostly on the EDF planes. But there you can see the difference, eh? Even 100 KV in the motor can mean
The night is coming, eh?
Yeah, the winter is coming, the spring.
Now wing, the night, eh?
The servos, the battery, like I have said, this is it, and a free blade propeller, and who cares about that? Let's open it and see it for
oh,
the first time.
Jesus Christ,
channel.
Yes.
Now, I just wonder why the hell this was already cut underneath, eh?
What?
The tape.
It was?
The tape was already cut, viewers. I didn't cut it, so hey. I'm wondering, eh? What the hell is this, eh? Who was opening my box before me? So this is it, I read it for the first time. I know what it is, and I will tell you why it is open. I know right now.
Why?
I will show it for the first time.
Huh?
Why?
Why? Why?
Why, my friends? Because of DSA. I will show you why it is open, because they have opened it in some warehouse. I think that this came from, yeah, of course. It came from Netherlands, and it is open because of this. Do you see this?
Gyro?
The gyro. A new gyro with, of course, the zip ties. And do you know why? Because I have seen on the reviews that in some cases, the gyro is not working good.
It says F4U.
Yeah. They say that this one, which is already installed in the plane, I must tell you this, that this one inside, they say that it is not working good, so you just take it out, put this one in, and again hook it with the zip ties, and that's it. I mean, for this, I wish I knew the Hobby King, because they were careful enough to see that there is the problem with this, and they have provided us with this, because can you imagine that you buy a plane and you can't fly because the gyro is not working good. I mean, that is nothing. But like I have said, they have put it in, but I have also seen the comments that many pilots, but in fact it did work good, so they have now the spare gyro. But of course I will also test it on my own if it is working, but still I will change it for the first flight because I don't want to risk nothing. Did I say it good?
Yes, finally you get to the point.
And now you know why the box was already open.
Yes.
And now let's see this. Of course, with this one we can start with the wing. Now I will cut this open because this plane I will assemble in these days, and as soon as we will have some cool weather, I won't risk this in too much wind. We will test it, because this plane, viewers, I mean, you can fly it in your wing, and I don't know, with your plane, who cares, eh? But I won't risk mine, because I still love to see it in one piece in my hangar doing company to this beautiful, sexy other place. And let's see it for the first time. 750 millimeters of funny. Do you see this, eh?
Yes.
Beautiful paint. The cables for the arms.
Yes, yes.
Let's see the bottom, of course. The servos already pre-installed and already hooked with the control horns. Do you see this, eh?
Yes.
I mean, on this place you don't need much assembly, but I will tell you that what you need to do on this plane is a pure joy to assemble. The only thing that you need to, I don't know, I think that on this one I have only assembled the back of the plane with the screws, but in fact it would be better if I had put some glue inside, because it is a little wobbly. But you will see, of course, in the instruction manual what they say, if we needed to glue it or not. That is for later.
Yes.
Let's check, of course, the horizontal stabilizer, which,
what?
Yeah, on this one, oh wait, this one will need the gluing, I can see already, because do you see this? Now, of course, it is already prepared for you. You do loosen this a little and do check it, eh? Because on this one, look at this, I don't know. If maybe this was because of the landings. No, I was flying this plane 3 times, but do you see this, eh?
Oh.
Do you see this?
Maybe you will just put in some hinges.
Good thing that I have saw this. Now I can't say, because you see here, do you see this, eh? On one landing, on the two grass, when I have landed that time a little crazy, it did hit here, do you see this, eh? So maybe this crack is, do you see here, it was hit here, so maybe this was from the crash, but I don't know. Of course, after a few flights with the plane, do check a little, because these are the foam hinges. Show this, and I can see already, like I have said, that this will be some gluing involved, but this will be the gluing, which you will glue with pleasure.
Yes.
Because in the meanwhile, you will get familiar with your plane.
Horizontal.
At least
vertical.
At least some work, eh?
This is the vertical stabilizer.
The vertical stabilizer.
Don't fold it down, yes.
Oh, do a little this, but this one is already loosened, but do you see this, eh? How sexy it works, eh? You just stuck it in, show this to the viewers, and of course when you will be pushing your rudder, I think that the same one as for the tailwheel, it will push this rudder on the back of the plane. Now, of course, this one wouldn't be complete if it doesn't have beautiful and sexy
fuel tanks.
Fuel tanks, which you have the option at this point, or maybe you can do something for yourself with the magnets. Can you imagine? I mean, it would be good if you have at home some magnets from the modular store that you can put yourself this fuel tanks on the magnets, because without them, I mean, they will not make a lot of drag, but still they will make some drag. And if you will be landing on the belly without the wheels, I don't think that you want to have the fuel tanks on. But it's really easy. Look at this, eh? How hard it would be. Look, but it looks so much sexier. Do you see this?
Yeah, of course, of scale. Course.
I will leave the wheels on my plane here because I will try to land on the carpet. So this, I think that I will glue these fuel tanks in. But like I have said, if you try to land on the belly, do make yourself something that you will be able to take them out there.
Yes.
Let's check what's here. We have one small box inside. Some goodies, there might be some cables or something inside here.
Uh-huh.
Oh!
Well, what's this?
Oh, 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 Captain Blush! Of course!
Velcro?
The screw, the antenna and the Velcro. But look at this! I didn't even know, I didn't check on the picture. Yeah, of course, do you see that thing?
Yes.
It has all kind of rockets underneath, eh? Look at this, eh?
Uh-huh.
And they look pretty sexy for such a small size. Look how sexy they are done for such a small size. Because hey, for these rockets, hey, feel me.
Yes.
For these rockets, I will salute Hobby King, because you know why? Because even on my 1.7 meter Corsair that I have from the FMS, do you remember in what kind of shape the rockets came with the plane? They were all banded, eh?
Uh-huh.
They were banded so bad that I didn't even put them on the plane because they look silly. But this one is so small and still it has so sexy scale rockets. I mean, this is unbelievable. And of course, on this one, I will put the rockets on because with these two flights that we will fill this plane, we want to see it fully loaded, eh, and ready for the action.
Yes.
Did I say it good?
Good set, yes.
One more thing, eh?
What?
There's something inside.
Hey, what's this, eh?
Aha, of course. The wheels, eh?
Uh-huh.
And can you imagine that in fact they're pretty big enough that you can still take off from our magic carpet? I mean, they will even work if you have some grass, short-cutted grass like in golf. But for us, even our magic carpet was good enough that I was able to take off with this one and with this one.
Yes.
And I will even take off with this one this time, because I just love to take off on the wheels. And of course, on the second flight, we will hand launch it for you. But you have seen on these previous two planes that hand launch is even more easier than to take off, because if you put the gyro on, I mean, that's it, eh? You can't crash the plane, no way. Oh, this is really good pack, eh? Look at this, eh?
Uh-huh.
This foam inside. Oh. Like this, I don't want to hurt the plane.
Uh-huh.
I don't want to hurt the plane here in the workshop, eh? Maybe it will be hurt on the runway, but I want to prevent it to be hurt here, eh? Oh!
Wow, look at this, eh?
Eh, the best part of every unboxing, of course, and the soul of the plane is the fuselage.
Yes.
In which we have, of course, the motor.
And the connector, I think,
is... Are you ready to see it for the first time?
JST, we'll see.
Look at this, eh?
Uh-huh.
And we will see where the hell is the compartment for the battery on this one. Because, of course, every plate...
Hey, I see is this a hatch on the top, or what's that?
Yeah, wait. I mean, look at this. I mean, look how sexy is this propeller. Do you see this? I will put closer to you.
Uh-huh.
On such a small plane, but it looks so sexy and scale. Tell me this, eh?
Yes, it
does. I mean, it's unbelievable. This spinner, look at the tips of the... I mean, the warbirds did have the tips yellow, so maybe in the future on all the warbirds... I mean, I love my tips to be white, but hey, the warbirds usually did have the yellow tips on the planes, eh? Look at this, eh? The stickers on, look at this. Everywhere you look, even the pilot on such a small plane, they all have the
don't
pilot
you have
inside.
One Corsair at home, this scheme?
No. Oh, yeah, of course I have. I have two.
Yeah,
the FMS 1.7 meter one, and I have yours. I have the Hangar 9 Corsair 1.7 meter one. pulls a one with 20cc, four stroke engine.
4 years old and never ran.
4 years, it's hanging in my hangar, waiting to be for the maiden flight. Maybe after March this year. Hey. But it's so beautiful. I mean, yours, it's so beautiful that I'm just afraid to fly it and crash it, because then I will cry. So that is why I rather fly this, because they are cheaper, and if I crash them, I don't cry so much. Of course, let's look at the back. You can see that this time it will be the glue construction. Do you see this, eh?
Yes.
Like you have seen, the rudder goes through here. Mm-hmm. It will stick to this one, because in fact you do have the steering back of the plane. And here you can see the gyro that you must replace. It's not hard. Do you see this?
Will
you just
it?
Cut it out. Yeah, I will change it. What the hell, eh? Huh, Captain Blush? I don't want to risk.
Well,
because
as long as it came with it, you can change it, eh?
Yeah. The gyro. Well, they have put it. I mean, hey, just for me, I will try it once like this, eh? With this gyro, I will take the prop off. I will try that just in case, but I will remove it because it's not worth to crash it. But I want to see if maybe this one is working, because I can use it in some other plane, maybe, yeah, or something like that.
How do you open
it? And of course, let's see where it does have the hatch. I don't know, Captain. What's this? Huh? It looks like here. Do you see this? Eh? Ah, you have the plastic. Oh, look at this. Eh?
Of course.
Show the inside.
Mm-hmm. Ah. So, one Velcro is already inside?
Yeah, of course it is!
No, you grab it and I will stuck out, pull out the...
Show the cables? Uh-huh. Yeah, of
JST.
Course.
JST?
Yeah, they have the same, they have all have the same connection on every single plane.
All labeled for you.
All labeled for you, for your convenience, and I think that this time, I don't know, I will check.
What?
Oh, you have pretty much place. Where I will stuck the battery to where? Of course, you must check the CG. Put a little nose heavy plane, not much, but maybe just a little, eh? So you will be one happy pilot. And I think that I will, it will be the same as on this one. I have stuck the battery all the way forward, because in fact here, I will put my 6-channel receiver. Because for this one, viewers, you need the 6-channel. 5 won't be, I mean, if you have 5 maybe, but 5-channel receivers, I don't even know if they exist. You will need to have 6-channel, because on 1-channel you will use to turn on the gyro for you.
Now put it a bit together.
And this is unbelievable, viewers. Unbelievable, eh? Look at this, eh? You just put this inside here. A little glue.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, this one will come on later. Uh-huh, it will be like this.
Yeah, just thinking what
the front doing. Goes inside here, because here you have, in fact, a little wood. Do you see this, eh?
Yes.
It will go here. Look at this, eh? No, these planes are so sexy to assemble. It is unbelievable how much you will enjoy this. And of course, I will just put it a little here like this.
Well, that's pretty much it, eh?
And that's it, eh?
Hey, to tell you the truth, it
all
looks...
All that you need to do is put out the wheels on and the rocks, and this is unbelievable.
It looks the most sexy of all three.
Yeah, but tell me. I mean, I will also put this one like this, so we can see the difference. I mean, now look here, hey, go here, Captain Blush, around the table. Go around the table. I will put this away so we won't even see it. And show the viewers all three planes. I mean, this is, I will even remove this. And now go around and look at this, eh? Huh? Mm-hmm. And tell me that this is not a sexy picture. Tell me, Captain Blush.
Yes.
And look how happy those other two planes are right now, because they have got the fellow plane.
Hey, these pilots are the triplets, eh?
Yeah, of course they are. They're all brothers, eh? Can you imagine?
They are all the same, eh?
Yeah. There must have been the five brothers. How do you call the twins?
No. But yeah, twins. They are two.
Yeah, they can't be
triplets
twins.
Are three.
Yeah, but quadruplets are what?
Fifteenths.
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 I mean, they don't all do look alike, eh?
Yes.
And this is unbelievable. I mean, if you could only see. I just wish that the camera would do the justice sometimes to the planes, because like I have said, in the real, if you look at, if I'm looking the plane right now, believe me, it's 100,000 times more beautiful than you see it on the camera. Even on the camera it does look good, but in, this is unbelievable. Look how sexy, this is unbelievable. And do you know what the most beautiful thing about this small collection of the planes? Because they're so small, you don't even need to disassemble them, eh? You can take all three or four or five if you have them on the runway at the same time in your car. But even more beautiful is, If you have the your hangar, your man cave, or the workshop, or maybe even in your living room, hey, they are so small but still so scale that you can put them on display in your house. Hey, and believe me, if someone will come, even the kids, hey, they go around, oh my dad, this is so sexy. Oh, I want to have a plane like this someday. Huh? Tell me. And of course, you will have the topic for your conversation. Because to talk about the RC plane, say, I can't find better topic to talk about, huh, Captain Luffy?
Yes.
This is unbelievable. So this is it. What to tell at the end? Well, hey, I can tell you right now, like I have known with previous two planes, that this plane will fly good. There is no other way, huh? It will fly good, and I know right now that it will look so sexy in the air.
Yes.
And with this gyro assist, hey, this is one hell of a plane that will give you hours and hours of perfect fun. So this is it. Pilot Robert and Captain Blas signing off from Slovenia with another, with the third part of this sexy Hobby King collection of the Warbirds. Amazing 750mm wingspan Corsair, the racing death that will run on free cell, and I can't wait to test it. Now I will just tell you this quick, that in fact you can also fly this plane on two cell batteries, Captain Blas. I don't think that even you know this.
No, I didn't.
Of course, it must be a little bigger to get the same weight, but you can also fly on 2S, and even on 2S they fly pretty good. But one cell more, that means a little more rotation for the fans, for the prop, if you need, if you are in the hurry or in some screwing up situation that you want to save the plane, sometimes it comes handy if you have one cell more for that extra rotations and for that extra thrust and power on the plane. Is it Captain Blush enough?
Yes.
So Captain Blush, quick! Because at this point, I will bring the tools here and I will assemble this plane with the most pleasure ever. And I can't wait to test the gyro if it's working or not. So this is it. Viewers will love you. Well, of course, expect more. And I can't wait to see this sexy Corsair, the iconic plane of the World War on our runway, ruling the sky, say.
Yes.
And don't forget to click on something. At least you can click thumb up on this video and you can click on the subscription button or you can click in our store, even there. Eh? Because if you visit our store, you will become the Pretentious Brothers
member
of our club of the hardcore amateur pilots, eh? Who loves to have good fun. So this is it. Enough Captain Blush.
Yes.
See you pretty soon, eh?